Good evening and welcome to the 13th Regulators and Policymakers Retreat being organized by IPPI here in Goa. We're in day two and have the pleasure of congratulating Mr. Ramesh Narayanan, who is the CEO of BSES in the Yamuna area, that is BYPL. Congratulations, sir, on winning the award for the best, most improved DISCOM, sir. So we'd like to know, how was this possible, given the fact that the particular area of Delhi that you service is one of the most difficult areas for a DISCOM to be, providing electricity and getting bills out and collecting payments on time.
True. In fact, we serve in the east and central Delhi, and that's where the poorest of the poor live. So there were about 300 colonies which were unelectrified. So people were resorting to, power theft. So first we electrified all the 300 colonies through HVDS system. We then campaigned with the people, put electronic meters 100%, and we introduced state-of-the-art IT technology. And it is through the engagement with the people, a good solid political will which we received all through this 10 years. And all this helped us to bring down the loss level from 63% at the time when we inherited 2002 to a current level of about 17%. So this is unprecedented. This is, it's a big achievement. I don't remember any country which might have achieved this kind of a record. So that's what was possible when you engage people, when you have political support, and you have a committed DISCOM.
So let's understand this for the benefit of our viewers. At the time when you started the reform process and took over the reins of the company, you were losing 63% of energy that you were supplying to consumers.
That's right.
Right? So you're losing more energy than you were gaining.
Absolutely. Right? Absolutely.
So this means out of efficiency, 60, out of every 100 units you sold, you didn't get
payment. Two-thirds of the unit was lost.
Lost, absolutely.
Yeah.
Right? So how did you start off on this difficult journey, sir, at that point of time?
We just sized up the problem. So we knew that why people were resorting to, electricity theft. They were not getting legal connections. So, on some pretext or the other, we're calling them unauthorized colonies or we are calling them jugi jopri clusters, and we were not electrifying those areas. So we electrified all those pockets, through HVDS system. The regulators supported it, the government supported it, and we as a DISCOM invested money on that, and it was money worth spent. And then we put reliable electronic meters, which are as per act, and then we introduced IT system everywhere, which eliminated human factor.
Right. Now, the problem there, sir, was the fact that if you give any service to a jhukki jhopri wala, you are basically legitimizing his hold or his right on that land.
No, it's not like that. You see, if you give a consumer a basic needs of electricity and water, it does not mean that he ends up owning that place.
Okay.
And you provide telecommunication to people.
Right.
So these are basic necessities.
Right.
So if you don't give them those kind of electricity and water,
right,
then they will resort to all wrong means to achieve
right.
it.
Right.
Because how can a person live without water, without electricity?
So
he needs
saying,
it.
So what we're saying is now these people are actually paying for the electricity.
Yeah, they're paying. See, they were otherwise paying to a whole lot of illegal arrangements where, somebody would steal that power in bulk and then retail it to them and they would get exploited. But now when they get a legal connection, they're all very willing consumers. So that's how we could achieve it. So this was a big lesson learned for us, that when you electrify the poor colonies, actually they become legal consumers and they pay regularly. So our collection efficiencies have improved, our processes have improved, so and the people don't have to resort to wrong means.
This is quite revolutionary, sir. This
yeah.
means that even in the jhukki jhopris of Mumbai and the slums, and maybe even in the villages, probably it's possible to electrify and actually get your money's worth out.
Absolutely. You see, people today realize that, if they want sustained supply of power, reliable supply of power, quality of power, then they got to also follow commercial principles. When they receive these services, they have to pay for it. And people are very willing to do it
right.
because they know the cost of not having it is much more
right.
than, the cost of paying for those services.
So another feather in your cap is the fact that you are now able to demarcate the area that you're supplying to, so that nebulous concept has now gone.
Yeah.
So you know who your consumers are. Tell us more about the success.
Yeah, in fact, you see, there is no pendency of connections at all. So today we provide service, I mean, connections on call. We, you know, we have enabled load enhancement on immediately on request. You know, you have to simplify process. You have to provide services reliably. So if you do that, people are willing to, you know, work with you and then see that the sector becomes efficient. So this is very much doable. You know, people are very, very sensitive to a reliable supply, to a quality supply. So you've got to provide them the service. That's it.
So the fact remains that all the three DISCOMs in Delhi have done a very good job. And this is well recognized all throughout India.
Yeah.
Then why is it so that Delhi has been the only power market where privatization has happened, not on a franchise basis, but on the entire asset transfer and everything basis? And why hasn't this model been replicated all throughout India as yet?
I think somewhere we lack the communication about the success of Delhi. Probably we got to take this success story all through the country and then dispel all those doubts which people have on their mind. And I think, you know, this is the salvation for the sector. So I think, you know, if we lack something, it is our communication. We have not taken this success story to every nook and corner. So when people realize about the success story, they are going to be very willing people for change.
So what is the role of the government and the political class in implementing this kind of change?
The government, you know, you need a political will. See, you, the government has to stand by you during this process of change. And we've been very fortunate that we had a rock solid support all through this difficult transition time. So today, if Delhi has been successful, it's because of this kind of a support we receive from the policymakers, from all law enforcing agencies, and the people at large.
Great. So finally, we'd like to know, in the morning session that we had on the distribution end, where we had a number of speakers, including from our DISCOM and the regulators, etc. One of the ideas that was being mooted that it might make sense in the longer term to go towards separation of wires and supply.
Yeah, in fact, power is a concurrent subject. If you look at the Indian power sector development in the last 20 years, after the power sector reform initiated by our current Prime Minister as the then Finance Minister in 1992, in 1992, we had an installed generation capacity of 65,000 megawatt. And today, in 2012, in 20 years' time, we have an installed capacity of 2,06,000 megawatt. So that's 210% growth. Okay, but there has not been a matching growth in the transmission and distribution sector. Now, if you look at the net demand on our network against an installed capacity of 2,06,000 megawatt, we are servicing just 125,000 megawatt in the grid. It does not mean we have a surplus of 80,000 megawatt. It means that we don't have those wires and those transmission lines to take the power to the starving consumers. Okay, so if you have to accelerate development on the distribution and transmission side,
yes,
one option could be that you segregate the supply and the the wire business. And if you segregate that, the wire could be implemented on a typical line like that of a generation project. It could be project financed, whereas the supply part, it cannot be project financed of the nature of its business. So because there is nobody underwriting or guaranteeing that they would be paying till they receive the service, whereas in a wire business, the off-taker could be underwriting that kind of a agreement. So that is how you could accelerate development. It is very important. And maybe because of the concurrent nature, when you segregate these two lines, you can build up wire as a central project, like the way we tried for the rural electrification. The same way, the wire could be established all over the country through a centralized assistance, and the content could be left to the respective state utility to manage. You know, so you don't constrain the infrastructure, so that whatever development happens on the generation side actually percolates
right.
to the end user.
Thank you so much for your time, Mr. Narayanan.
My pleasure.
And congratulations once again on winning.
Thanks a lot. Thanks a lot. Thank
Have
you.
Have a good stay at the retreat, sir.
Thank you.